Okay, welcome back from that commercial break. You're still watching Selling Talk, and I'm still your girl, Savaria Hughes. And like I told you from the beginning, if you know you've just joined us right about now, make sure that you sit in and get ready, because we are talking about the youth for today. I was like, we have to sacrifice this episode for the youth, because guys, the youth out there, you are dealing with things and you do not know how to get out of them, or you feel like you are alone and yet you are not. So today, we're going to be clarifying for you a few, of course not all, but a few of those things that you feel like are wrong, yet they're just no more. You know, you get. So, Maweto, we all have had stories of dancers that have come out and they're like, they touch, they misbehave. So you as a dancer, and you've been behind stage, you've been performing on platforms where with big artists like Fireboy, like Diamond Platnumz. So how is it backstage? Like what actually goes on backstage? Are those things true, or?
Maybe it may be true for some dancers, but for me it's not, because the way you carry yourself is how people are going to take you. If you carry your, exactly, they'll respect you. Mm. And as a brand, you have to brand yourself. You have to know when to do some things and when not to do them, you know. I can't be around Fireboy and I'm overthrowing myself around Fireboy. What will he think of me? Like, I'm going to perform.
Some dancers do, and they embarrass
this them. Ugandan dancer came and threw herself on me, and she, you know, like that kind of remark, I wouldn't want that for my brand.
Or even someone embarrassed on stage.
Exactly. You know, even the way I dance, actually, I dance totally different in a way of that I cannot even seduce, an artist, either Ruga or Rema. It's all professional, you know. It's all professional. And it has been, like, those guys have been respectful. The ones that I work with, Kiss Daniel, Fireboy, Ruga, to name a few, we've been, like, having that connection of professionalism only.
Now I'm confused, because like you're saying, it's all about branding.
Exactly.
But then some girls be like, oh, you reach there, yeah, you care about your brand, but then you reach a point and you be like, but they force some of them, like, force themselves.
But who can
you.
Force you, like, seriously?
Who can force you? Like, you're grown up.
Why do you those?
Unless what might you want. Unless you want.
Like, you say he has forced you, but how did you reach there?
Why exactly. Are those rough people, like,
unless you also want.
An artist can drag you from stage to people who can drag you.
You also be having that urban excitement of, this is an artist from Nigeria.
Okay. The question that is at hand that has been going on social media, and are people now, like, our viewers want to be knowing what exactly they should do. Why is it important to hustle? Like, to you as a human being, why is it important to hustle? Like, leave alone getting, like, hustling, getting just hard money. There is hustling and you get assets, you can get land, you can get wealth. So why is it important to hustle, you as a person? Because I know what you're doing, you're working for the future. You're not working for, like, right now.
No.
So, yeah, why do you think it's really important to hustle?
Well, hustling, first of all, is a foundation of maturity, you know. When you're starting to grow up, you start realizing how life moves on, how it works. You're not going to be at your parents' home forever. And how to live your life, you know. You have to start, like, your mind. There's a time when I sit at home, like, for a full week, I'm not doing anything. And I'm sad, because I'm used to, like, work.
Eating.
Exactly.
However much you're eating something.
Exactly.
Like, really, I need to wake up.
I need to start.
I need to have this. I need to have a goal in life.
But
you have
no
goal, obviously. You need to have a house. You need to have a lot of things, because we are all human beings. We need stuff.
Speaking about the hustling topic, that brings about what I wanted to talk about, baby daddies. Girls are there. By the way, this is what the youth are facing. The youth these days have an abundance of. Is it abundance? Does it mean you have a lot, or there is less? Okay, there is less. They didn't have the opportunity to go to school, so they don't have those levels of education like majority of people have. That's what the youth are facing right now. So most of them, they tend to deal with criminality. Like, they wanna engage themselves in crimes. They want to, like, do things that are gonna, like, bring the youth down, do drugs and all that. So girls these days, most especially those who have said the prostitutes that lying about, cause Munai, not everybody has the means to become who they want to become. So you find up, these girls end up, like, getting rich men and having this thing in their mind. Oh, let me have a child for this guy, I'll be set for life. do you think what they are doing is okay? Like, is there some good in it, or why it's completely wrong, you as you?
Okay, me, all I know is that not every rich man is responsible. You can get that baby, but you'll suffer with the baby again, I'm telling you. As if the dad has already died, but...
Come here, that's all
it's around, just okay.
And even
you
refuse to take care of the baby.
So do you think, is it why most girls are having, like, are crying these things? Oh, we are poor. Is it their mindset? Or it's what they put themselves into that makes them...
It's worry? A choice, Savaria. It's a choice at the end of the day. You're not going to... Okay, let me take you back to the statement that you said girls, they do like some crime, taking drugs and all that. Like, there is school. There is UPE nowadays. There are schools whereby you don't... Free of charge. You choose to either go to school or go on the streets and do...
Some are even forced to
bad
go to
things.
School.
Exactly.
After they'll end up saying things are bad for
them. But then at the end of the day, they choose themselves. So we don't feel sorry for none. We don't feel sorry for none.
You
and
choose your
that
life.
You
choose your life.
Exactly.
You know how to set your goals.
What if those things happen to them without, like, their knowledge? You know, like, we have we have had several cases in Uganda whereby girls are raped. Actually, we are talking too much of the girl perspective. Mr. Baba, first good people who are watching us right now. So, I first ask you a question there.
Hey viewers, this is Babito the Baba, manager Spectra Sound Kavalagala. I'm glad to see you. I'm here to welcome the viewers.
Okay, so Babito, you have seen a lot of girls, and you've been in Kampala nightlife. You've been to bars, you've seen a lot of girls. Some of them, I'm very sure, they've come and they're like, Babito, we are going home today. So what are some of those mistakes that you see girls do in bars that they should not be doing?
What I can say, those girls in the bar, they normally call them slay queens or cheap girls or all those words, yeah? But true. Yeah, they call them cheap girls. But what I can say, the mistake they do, it's when she meets you for the first time, she expects two things, money and hangout.
Yeah, okay.
That the problem that we meet with guys. But most of our guys, most of we guys, we want to, okay, we are in bar, but for short time, not every day, not every weekend, but we are there to have fun. So when I meet you, I think like, I'm meeting someone also who has the same thoughts like mine. And those we are here to enjoy. Tomorrow you're going to work. Not every day you're asking me money. Not every day you're asking me going out.
But you have
for
a choice
dinner.
As a man.
Yeah,
to
but
either refuse to be into it or out.
But sometimes when I refuse, you like
but no one
you
can
say this
no,
guy is broke.
No.
She will say this guy. She will say this guy is broke.
You're broke.
I refuse
are you
he, for
like
outing.
Are you how I like are you how I for something or husband?
No, of course I'm dating you. Like it's I find
dating.
I find in the bar.
Dating.
Yeah, I
that means
but
you also came
he's
with an
not
aim.
Wrong. Most girls when they
I find you
fight,
in the bar, remember that. So you think
we're
every
dating.
Day it will be like bar talk, it will be going out. Not every day. Remember that they also have a lot of things to do. It's not every day that
okay,
I have to
then you
go.
Have to quit, I think. Yeah.
But do you know that when I meet in the bar, when I call you tomorrow, you'll say, where are we going today?
Obviously, it's her choice, and it's also your choice to refuse.
And when I say no, let us...
On what he said, Queen, let's be obvious. Queen, okay, like, no, let's be real. If I told you met a guy today in a bar, you guys, like, mashed up, like, you connected, blah, 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 then he calls you up tomorrow, obviously.
I'll look for another location.
Obviously, no, if you've liked the guy and you've decided to see him again, obviously, you're not going to expect him to tell you, come to my house. You're going to expect him to take you on a date as a lady, right?
But me, right?
The first question.
Okay, yes, but me, most times, I don't date guys from bars. I just use them for my
because
business.
Because what if you've got her, like, you've got him, wait, what are you saying? Some of us
for business.
Some of us landed. Okay, guys, let us go for a short commercial break. When we come back, we're still talking about these things. Zenaka, but let's come back.